I'm Anil Kumar. Welcome to my series on power patterns and their applications. In this video, we'll explore the patterns of numbers 3 to the power of n, where n could be any whole number. Related to this, we have two questions here. Use the patterns to find the last or the unit digit of the following powers: 3 to the power of 22, 5, 3 to the power of 52, 3 to the power of 25. And then we have a related question number 4, which is write power of 3 that is greater than 3 to the power of 100 and have last digit of 7. You can always pause the video, answer the question, and then look into my suggestions. Now, let us check the pattern rule by writing what are the values for 3 to the power of 1, 3 to the power of 2, 3 to the power of 3, 3 to the power of 4, 3 to the power of 5, 3 to the power of 6, and so on. So, well, 3 to the power of 1 is 3, number itself, times 2. 3 to the power of 2 is 3 times 3, twice. You multiply with 9. 3 to the power of 3 is 27. So, you can multiply the previous number by 3 to get the next power. Correct. So, we get 81 here. Multiply 81 by 3 to write here. So, we get 324. Multiply by 3. 3 times 3 is 3 times 3 is 9, so we get 9 here, and 3 times 4 is 12, 2 and 1, 7, 29, and so on. So what you really notice at these powers, the place value is what? So place value is 3, 9, 7, 1. And then again, this set of values repeat. We again have 3, 9, and if you continue, this pattern repeats. Correct? So from this pattern rule, we can say in general that if I have 3 to the power of n, right, and if I divide n by 4, in that case, remainder will decide the unit's digit. Is that clear to you, right? So dividing by 4, if the remainder is 1, then you get 3 as your unit digit. If the remainder is 2, then the unit digit will be 9. If it is 3, it will be 7. 4 means it goes evenly, remainder is 0, right? Then you get 1 as your answer, correct? So basically, if we have, we can now write the rule. So if the remainder could be 1, it could be 2. It could be 3 or it could be 0. You could have written 0 in the beginning also. But we're just following this pattern. So if it is 1, the unit's place will be 3. If it is 2, unit's place will be 9. If it is 3, it will be 7. And if the remainder is 0, then it is going to be 1. Like 3 to the power of 0 is 1. Does it make sense to you, right? Okay. Now using this pattern rule, let us answer our questions. So let's begin with 3 to the power of 22. So 3 to the power of 22 will actually divide 22 by 4, right? So when you divide 22 by 4, it goes 5 times with the remainder of 2. Now since the remainder is 2, what is the unit's place? Well, if the remainder is 2, the unit place is 9. So this corresponds to unit's place of 9. Clear? That number 2 corresponds to unit place of 9. So we get our answer here, and that is going to be 9 for the first case. In the second case, we have 3 to the power of 52. So let's again divide 52 by 4, and we go 1 and 3, 13 times, remainder is 0. Now since the remainder is 0, we get power as 1, correct? As mentioned here. So it is going to be 1, and this remainder, the 1's place or the last digit or the unit digit will be 1. So this question could be asked in different ways. Sometimes we say last or 1's or unit digit, correct? The C part is 3 to the power 25. So if I divide 25 by 4, we get 6 times 24 and remainder is 1. And for remainder 1, it is 3. Clear? So here the remainder is 3. That is how we could answer the question. Now, question number 4 here is, write powers of 3 that are greater than 3 to the power of 100 and have last digit as 7. So last digit of 7 means what? It means what? It means that the remainder should be 3, right? So we are looking into this portion, remainder being 3. We know 3 to the power of 100, it goes evenly with 4, and therefore, what do we expect for 3 to the power of 100 and 3? So that should give you the last digit as asked for, which is 7. It does make sense. So in our case, the answer has to be 3 to the power of 103. The answers can vary, of course. You could add 4 to this, 107, 102. Like that, you can have many. Keep on adding 4, right? So that is how we get. So any multiple of 4 plus 3 is your exponent for this particular case. I hope that makes sense. Feel free to write your comment, share your views, and if you like and subscribe to my videos, that'd be great. Thanks for your time and all the best.